Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yesterday, some of the students again three times submitted the Google form. Why? They are confused. I have sent the Google form. So fill up it within 1 hour of class and send it to me.
Hello, ma'am.
No confusion there. Don't fill up 2 times, 3 times. That's creating problem for me.
Ma'am.
Understand all of you?
Ma'am.
Ask. Say.
Ma'am, ek hi form se har din attendance hoga.
What? हाँ वही तो बोल रहे हैं, समझ में नहीं आया है. एक गूगल फॉर्म का लिंक भेजा गया है, उस फॉर्म से हर दिन करो मेरे पास चला आएगा. क्या जरूरत है हर दिन मुझे नया गूगल फॉर्म भेजने की? सेम गूगल फॉर्म फ्रॉम द सेम लिंक यू विल गिव योर अटेंडेंस. अंडरस्टैंड एवरीवन, जैसे लिंक क्लास का भेजा जाता है वैसे नहीं है गूगल फॉर्म के लिए. सेम गूगल फॉर्म इज गिवेन, सेम लिंक इज गिवेन. And fill up it and submit. Don't be confused. Class link is given every day, but the link of the Google form is the same, and it was sent earlier. Fill up the form and submit. Just wait. So understand everyone. Now up to 42 students are here. Why are you coming late? Why are you joining late? So after screen sharing, it is not possible to allow anyone. So if you waste your time of your class, then that will create problem for you all. Two students left.
सो लास्ट डे आई डिस्कस्ड डैम वाइब्रेशन द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. आई डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अनडैम्प्ड मोशन एंड डैम्प्ड मोशन, डैम्प्ड वाइब्रेशन एंड द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ डैम्प्ड वाइब्रेशन एंड ऑल्सो द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. There were three cases. One was heavy damping. That two cases I discussed yesterday, and both the cases were non-oscillatory. That means there was no oscillation. Now today, that is remaining, that I will discuss light damping case. So now it is 44 students here. So two students are absent till now. Now not possible for me to wait more, so I am just sharing my screen. And if I Vishal Yadav.
Yes ma'am. Good morning ma'am.
Are you getting my
yes,
call?
Ma'am.
So why are you late? For the remaining 3 to 4 students, I am waiting and wasting the time of the class. And I will take steps after that. If you join late in this way, if any student, then he or she will be punished for that. So for you and another student remaining, I will check the attendance. And then I will take the decision that what I will do. Warning you all. Roll number one.
मैं बाहर आया था, बस काम था, कुछ पैसे से
निकाल रही थी. हजार है, तुम कहाँ हो मुझे पता नहीं है, मुझे जानना भी नहीं है. This is your scheduled class time from 10 a.m. and you will be present there. Roll number one.
Yes, ma'am.
Roll number 1, present or not?
Yes, ma'am, present.
2. Roll number 34 is absent for today. So one student, that is roll number 34, is absent today. Okay? And send your attendance after the class in the same Google form. Now I'm sharing my screen. Is the screen visible?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Wait. Now is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No.
So these things I discussed, that what is undamped motion, what is damped motion, then equation of motion of damped vibration, and it was d2x by dt square plus 2k dx dt plus omega square x equal to 0. That was equation number 2. And from there, taking the trial solution method and solving the differential equation. So it was solved, and three cases arised. First one is heavy damping case, where k was greater than omega, and for there, for t equal to infinity, x tends to 0. That is, displacement tends to 0. After infinite time. Now for critical damping case, same, there was no oscillation, and but here the difference between the overdamped motion and critically damped motion is that in both cases displacement tends to zero at time t tends to infinity, but in critical damping motion it comes tends to zero much more rapidly than the overdamped motion. Displacement tends to zero, so you can say you can see the graph is here behind of the overdamped motion, and the displacement is going to zero, tends to zero at t tends to infinity much more rapidly than the overdamped motion. In both the cases displacement tends to zero, but in critical damped motion the displacement tends to zero much more rapidly than the overdamped motion. So in critical damping the particle tends to moves to equilibrium much more rapidly than the overdamped motion. This is non-oscillatory motion. Remember both the cases, that is overdamped motion and critical damping case, both are non-oscillatory. Now I am coming to oscillation. S3, that is light damping case or underdamped motion. Now what is the condition here for this case? That is K is less than omega. See, here K was greater than omega for heavy damping case. So remember this one, this may be given in MCQ question. So in heavy damping case, K was greater than omega. In critical damping case, K was tends to omega. And in light damping case or underdamped motion, K was less than omega. K is less than omega here. So one root over term was there. In every case, I have discussed this root over term, that is root over K square minus omega square. So as K is less than omega, so we will get one imaginary quantity, that is I we will get as K is less than omega. In the first case, K was greater than omega, so no problem for that. So no minus sign is there, but here you are getting what? One minus, that means inside the root over, we are getting the minus sign as K is less than omega. So I am writing like this, that is I into root over omega square minus K square. So now this term, this is different one, that is this is root over omega square minus K square, that term I am writing as omega dash. So I into omega dash. So root over K square minus omega square, this term I am representing as I omega dash. Omega and omega dash, they are different here. So this is the damped frequency and here it is the natural one. Now omega dash equal to omega square minus K square, that I have written. Now our equation was X, what was our equation previously? See, here I am coming here. So in place of root over K square minus omega square, I am writing I omega dash. So I omega dash I am writing. So again, going here. So e to the power x, displacement x equal to e to the power minus kt into A e to the power I omega dash t plus B into e to the power minus I omega dash t. From where I am getting this? I am getting this from where? So x equal to e to the power minus kt A e to the power root over k square minus omega square is I omega dash. So A e to the power I omega dash into t plus B into e to the power minus. Minus sign is already there. So minus I omega dash into t. So this is our expression of displacement now for underdamped motion or light damping case. So x is this. Now what I am doing, just breaking it.
In that equation there was root over k square minus omega square, but here the equation is root over omega square minus k square, and that is omega dash. So how can we replace?
How can means what? What is the condition? If k is less than omega, so if you calculate k square minus omega square, you will get plus sign or minus sign? K is less than omega. So k square minus omega square, you will get minus sign or plus sign?
Root over minus sign.
I am not saying anything. I am saying that k square minus omega square, not root over anything. K square minus omega square, you will get plus or minus? If k is less than omega, minus. So minus of root over what? Root over minus 1 equal to I. So that I have written.
But ma'am, in that equation, it was root over k square minus omega square.
So why you are not understanding? In this equation, it is root over k square minus omega square. So that is equal to what?
I
into?
Root over omega square minus k square.
So in place of root over k square minus omega square, can I write I into root over omega square minus k square?
Yes, ma'am.
So that I have written.
No, I'm just telling this in this equation, x equal to e to the power minus kt. In this equation, a e to the power minus I here.
What is the problem? I'm not understanding. Why you are not understanding? Where I omega dash t it is written?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to the previous slide. Why you are not understanding? Observe very carefully. Listen very carefully. Otherwise, if you when I ask silly questions, it will waste time. See here, equation number 5. What is the problem? In this equation, I have written the value, na? Come to equation number 5.
Okay, ma'am, I get that.
No. Say, what is your problem? I have to judge. Come to equation number 5. Say, what is written there? You just read.
E to the power minus kt.
E to the power minus kt, that is outside. That is now I am not considering. Inside the bracket term, I am considering. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So inside the bracket, what is there? A?
E to the power root over k square minus omega square.
That's square into t. So e to the power minus k square minus omega square into t. Is it written there? And e to the power plus, actually in the first term, e to the power plus k square minus omega square into t is there. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. So if I write it inside the root over, that is inside the root over, I am writing minus, okay, into omega square minus k square. Understand or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Inside the root over, I am writing as k is less than omega, so I can't subtract lesser quantity. From the lesser quantity, we can't subtract. You know it. So I am writing it as omega square minus k square inside the bracket. Okay, as k is less than omega, so I am writing omega square minus k square inside the bracket. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
As omega is greater, but I can't write this because I can't change the form of the equation. Okay.
Yes.
So for that reason, I have to put one minus sign in front.
Yes.
Okay. So minus sign in front, I have to write. So minus of root over minus. It is inside the root over sign. So minus of root over is what?
I.
And inside the root over sign, it is not now k square minus omega square. As I have written I, so inside the root over, what is there? Omega square minus k square.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it?
Yes.
So e to the power I into inside the root over, what is there? Omega square minus
k square.
Okay. Now this root over omega square minus k square, I am taking the value as omega dash. Understand now?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, so e to the power ke saath dekho. E to the power kya hai? I hai. Uske saath hai root over omega square minus k square. Is it?
Yes.
Now, in the equation, it is given k square minus omega square root over. Is it?
Yes.
But I have written different thing here.
Yes.
So that different thing that I have written as omega dash.
Yes.
Okay. Now I am representing that omega dash, omega square. See here, I have written omega square minus k square as what?
I omega dash.
No. Root over omega square minus k square is what?
Omega dash.
So now clear for you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So just try to concentrate. Try to concentrate whatever I am teaching, whatever I am saying. Because if you are not concentrating, you will not understand. So it was initially root over k square minus omega square. That time I am changing because k is less than omega. I can't subtract k minus omega. You can't do. That is k square minus omega square. I can't write, so I'm writing it omega square minus k square as omega is greater, but I'm then changing the form of the equation. So I have to write one I, root over minus one I, root over minus one, actually I have to write. So root over minus one, suppose that o dash equal to, we are taking it as omega dash. Now it is actually say omega is the natural frequency when there is no damping, or your damping factor is k, okay? So k is the damping factor. Now here the value is decreasing, the omega dash is root over omega square minus k square, is k is zero, then omega dash equal to omega, understand? So there is no damping if k equal to zero. But if k increases, if k value increases, then omega dash value will
decrease.
So damping, if damping increases, omega dash kya hoga?
Ghatega.
Theek hai? So now this is the equation. X equal to the power minus kt into this year after that. This thing in terms of sine and cos, e to the power I theta, you know how to break cos theta plus I sine theta like this. So it is written like this, and combining cos term is written in one side and sine term is written in another side. So I am getting this. Is there any problem in this line, anyone? E to the power I theta, what is the form in terms of sine and cos?
Cos theta I sine theta.
Cos theta plus I sine theta.
So same here, e to the, in place of theta it is omega dash t. And with AB coefficients are here, constants values are here, so bracket, just simply write the values of e to the power I omega dash t and e to the power minus I omega dash t and combine the term, and you can write it in this way. Now taking assumption, but taking assumption a plus b equal to c sin phi. So a plus b equal to c sin phi I'm taking, and this term I into a minus b as c cos phi. Let us suppose now our this equation becomes x equal to e to the power minus kt. So a plus b equal to what? C sine phi. So c into sine phi, this is a plus b, remaining cos omega dash t. So written here, plus I into a minus b, this term equal to c cos phi. So I have written c cos phi, then sine of omega dash t. So written here, sine of omega dash t. So this is our expression of displacement now. Now that c is common part, so putting it outside. So x equal to c e to the power minus kt into, inside the bracket, what remains? Cos of omega dash t sine phi plus sine of omega dash t cos phi. So this is our expression of displacement now. So you know cos a plus b, sine a plus b, the form in this way. So cos of omega dash t sine phi plus sine of omega dash t cos phi. So I can write this bracketed term as sine of omega dash t plus phi. So final expression of displacement. So that this is the solution of the light damping case. So now equation A, this is x equal to c e to the power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus phi. Okay, is it?
Yes,
now see here, sine term is there, sine term is there, that means oscillation you will get. So depending on the value, money, that means it varies. Now the oscillation is there, first time you are getting oscillatory motion, and actually we know the equation of oscillation, you know it, it's a simple harmonic motion, you know the equation that x equal to a sine omega t plus theta. Say you know, all of you know that x equal to what? A sine, say, omega t plus theta. You know this type of expression for displacement, and this is the this is simple harmonic motion, the equation. Now here if I compare this as x equal to a sine omega dash t plus 5, same. Now A is what? What is amplitude? What is amplitude now? If I compare
C e to the power minus kt.
So C e to the power minus kt. This is the amplitude now. But this amplitude is not fixed. It is not constant amplitude. It is decreasing exponentially with time. T is the time. So e to the power minus kt is there. So it is decreasing exponentially. Whole amplitude is C to the power minus kt. So this is decreasing exponentially. This is not constant. In undamped motion, I can write that x equal to a sine omega t plus theta. A is the constant. But A is represented here as C into e to the power minus kt. But it is decreasing exponentially. So this is not equal to constant. Now it is written here that equation number A, that is damped oscillatory motion of frequency f. So this is the equation. If it is given, write down the equation of damped oscillatory motion. So damped oscillatory motion, the equation is x equal to c to the power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus 5. Now equation number A, that I said that amplitude decreases exponentially. So what is the amplitude? C into t to the power minus kt. This is the amplitude. It decreases exponentially with time. So what is the frequency here? So omega dash, we know omega dash by 2 pi, because omega, actually we know omega equal to 2 pi n, like this, but 2 pi f. Now here the frequency. Here what is the frequency? So this is omega dash by 2 pi. You know the value of omega dash, that is root over omega square minus k square divided by 2 pi. So common this term, put it outside omega. So here if you write it in this way, you will get omega by 2 pi, then 1 minus k square by omega square. So this is simple mathematical calculation. Just put it outside this omega term, then inside it, you will get 1 minus k square by omega square inside the root over term. Then what is this? Omega by 2 pi?
Frequency.
Frequency, but what? Natural frequency. When there is no damping. Understand?
Yes.
So omega by 2 pi equal to what? F0. That is undamped frequency. Frequency of undamped motion into this. So what is F? F is the damping frequency. What is F?
Damping frequency.
So damping frequency equal to omega dash by 2 pi. If I write here F0, then I have to write omega by 2 pi. If I write natural frequency F0, then I have to write omega by 2 pi. But I'm writing F, so equal to omega dash by 2 pi. The value of omega dash I have written here. Now putting that omega term outside, so 1 minus k square by omega square inside the root over. So inside the root over, it is written omega by 2 pi, and omega by 2 pi equal to your F0. So the relation between the damping frequency and the natural frequency, it is written as F equal to F0 root over 1 minus k square by omega square. So this is the relation between the two frequency, damping and natural frequency, and it is oscillatory case. This is oscillation is there. You are getting the term displacement. The equation for displacement, that is x equal to c into t to the power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus 5. So this is the expression of displacement. And you can see this is oscillatory motion. And what is the amplitude? If I compare this with x equal to a sine omega dash omega t plus theta like this, then a is constant. But here a is represented as c into t to the power minus kt. So this is the amplitude is c into t to the power minus kt. So it is decreasing exponentially with time. So this is the case of damped motion, but here damping is light, and the condition is given here as k is less than omega. So remember this, all these three conditions. In heavy damping case, k was greater than omega. In critical damping case, k is equal tends to omega, but in light damping case, k is less than omega. So this is only the oscillatory motion, that is light damping case, and the condition is k is less than omega. Now, and you all know that from this expression, the relation between the frequency, here damping frequency, and the natural frequency. So that is in damped vibration. From again, I'm just repeating that these are the two figures, that is the damp motion, this is damping. You can see the amplitude is decreasing exponentially. The last place oscillation is there, you can see the oscillation from the graph. And here in undamped motion, there is no damping, amplitude is not changing with time. And this is the damped motion, oscillatory motion, damped oscillatory motion. And this is the case of light damping case. Time is plotted along the x-axis and the displacement along the y-axis. And you can see that amplitude is decreasing exponentially with time. So the equation of damped vibration, that is the starting. Actually, I want to ask one question from here, that in equation number two, yesterday I also asked this question. So in equation number two, what is the equation of simple harmonic motion? Which term we have to eliminate if we want to write it as simple harmonic motion?
2k dx by dt. Okay.
So this is the extra term in damped vibration. Damped motion, this is the extra term. If k is zero, if I put k equal to zero, this becomes just the equation for differential equation for simple harmonic motion. Then taking the trial solution method, we have the general solution. And equation number five we have, then I have discussed three different cases. Heavy damping case where k is greater than omega. Here for t tends to infinity, x tends to zero, that the displacement tends to zero at t tends to infinity. And for critical damping case, the graph is shown here, but here the displacement tends to zero much more rapidly than the overdamped motion. Both are non-oscillatory motion. And in light damping case, k is less than omega. And from here, we have the expression for displacement. That is only the oscillation is here. This is only the case of oscillatory motion, x equal to c into t power minus kt sine of omega dash t plus phi. So this is the expression of displacement. Now amplitude decreases exponentially with time. What is this? Amplitude is c into t power minus kt. And we have the relation between the damping frequency and the frequency, natural frequency. So f equal to f0 root over 1 minus k square by omega square. So this is the expression that you have must remember. So the motion of the pendulum in air, the discharge of charge capacitor through an inductive coil, oscillation of coil in ballistic galvanometer, these are all the examples of damped oscillatory motion. Now I'm coming quality factor later, but before that I want to discuss the electrical circuit. Now, this is the example of damped vibration I am discussing for LCS circuit. So this is the figure, this is resistance. So screen sharing is on, now you can see the screen.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is resistance R is represented. That is the example of damped vibration I am discussing for LCS circuit. So this is R, this is L, and this is C. And this is the key, this is the battery. Now, when R equal to zero, the oscillation of the circuit is undamped with angular frequency omega zero. Omega zero, what is this? Is natural frequency, natural angular frequency. This is the frequency of undamped motion. Zero, whenever I am taking zero, so remember this is for undamped motion. Now that is omega zero equal to I'm discussing all the things. I will discuss the differential equation, I will solve it, everything I will discuss as I have discussed in damped vibration. Wait. See, here the resistance plays the part of a resistive or dissipative force analogous to that of friction and viscosity in case of Now, on pressing a key, this capacitor is charged. Listen very carefully. On pressing the key, the capacitor is charged, and when the key is released, the battery is thrown out of the circuit. And the capacitor starts discharging through the resistor. This V equal to what? Q by C. You know it. The voltage across the capacitor, capacitance is there. Capacitance, capacitor is there. So voltage across the capacitor, how we can write? V equal to Q by C. Do you know this? Do you know this? Voltage across the
capacitor,
can I write it? V equal to Q by C?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. EMF across the inductance. EMF across the inductance. Discuss simple harmonic motion in LC circuit. Then there was no R actually. Remember, LC circuit. There was no the way it oscillates. It executes simple harmonic motion. Have I discussed this thing? Oscillation in LC circuit. It executes simple harmonic motion.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Think about the examples of simple harmonic motion. So there, I discussed that the frequency of oscillation here, angular frequency, was equal to 1 by root over LC.
Yes,
that was, you have not learned.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, so in that was LC circuit. Which circuit it was? LC circuit. No R was there, no? There was R?
Only LC.
So it is written here. Actually, what I have taken? I have taken LCR circuit here. Okay, but if I put R equal to 0, then what is the circuit now? LC circuit? If R equal to 0 in the circuit, then what is the
LC circuit?
LC circuit. So in LC circuit, what is the expression of angular frequency? Root over 1 by LC?
Yes, ma'am.
So the resistance that creating the damping. Which is creating damping in LCR circuit?
Resistance.
So that I have written when R equal to 0, the oscillation of the circuit is undamped. No damping is there. Undamped means what? No damping is there. So now one student was asking question about this. The omega 0 equal to root over 1 by LC. Now what was his question? Tell me now. Tell me that you have understood. You were asking question about this. Now I have explained. Now tell me, have you understand or not? I am saying particular, I am asking that particular student who was asking question. You are wasting time. You have understand?
Yes, ma'am.
You asked me the question, no? Who are you?
Yes.
What, tell me your name?
Joy Chakraborty.
Joy Chakraborty, okay. Okay, very good. So Joy, now your question, your problem is solved or not?
Yes, ma'am, solved.
Have you any question till now? No,
ma'am.
So problem is solved. Okay. So initially in simple harmonic motion, I discussed LC circuit and I showed that it oscillates. That is a simple harmonically it oscillates. The frequency of oscillation, it was 1 by root over LC. Now here I am taking LCR circuit. And now if I put R equal to 0, so this is the undamped motion now, just like LC circuit with angular frequency omega 0 equal to root over LC. Now here, the voltage across the capacitor. Now I'm considering LCR circuit, not LC circuit, because this is the example of damped vibration. And so for that, I am including R with that LC circuit. Now it is totally LCR circuit. Now voltage across capacitor V equal to, that I also discussed then, L di by dt. I is the current through the circuit. So the EMF across inductance L, that is L di by dt. And the potential difference across R, this is I into R. So you know all these things. Now, since there is no external EMF, as the battery is out of the circuit, then from Kirchhoff's law, I can write, what I can write from Kirchhoff's law, we can write L into di by dt plus ir plus q by c equal to zero. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is this, all the terms I have explained, L di by dt plus ir plus q by c zero. Now I equal to what? Dt of q? I equal to what?
Dt
of dq by dt? Dq by dt? I equal to dq by dt? So di by dt is what?
D2q by dt square.
So di by dt. Yes. So di by dt, that remains as what? D2q by dt square. Okay. So I have replaced this di dt as d2q by dt square, and here it is ir. So what is I? I equal to
dt by dt.
DQ
by dt. So ir means r into dq by dt plus I have written q by c as it is. Now simple mathematically I have written that dividing by l, so dq by dt is d2q by dt square plus r by l into dq by dt plus q by lc. I have divided the whole equation by L. The whole equation is divided by L. So it is takes the form like this. So this is equation number one I'm giving. Okay. So this is the equation number one I'm giving. Now remember the differential equation for damped vibration. Mechanically, what I have write? What was written earlier? D2x by dt square plus A by mx plus b by m dx dt equal to zero. Just I have discussed.
Yes,
is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Then actually this, if you forward this thing, then come to this, that d2x by dt square equal to d2x by dt square plus 2k into dx by dt plus omega square x equal to zero. Now is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is the equation for damped vibration, equation number two. And for LC circuit, so equation, according to equation number two, I have d2x by dt square plus 2k into dx by dt plus omega square x equal to zero. This is the differential equation for damped vibration. This is equation number two. And the equation that I have from LC circuit, LCR circuit, what is this? D2q by dt square plus r by l dq by dt plus q by lc equal to zero. So these two equations are similar to each other, analogous. Okay. So Q is analogous to which?
X.
Here it is d2q by dt square. Now here it is d2x by dt square. Now Q is analogous to which?
X.
X.
X. So Q is analogous to X. Okay. And here it is r by l dq by dt. And here it is 2k dx by dt. So 2k, so what I can write? 2k equal to r by l, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now q by lc equal to omega square x?
Yes.
Q by lc omega square x? Okay. Now q is analogous to x. So what is omega square?
1 by LC.
Okay. So these two equations are analogous. So X in equation 2 is analogous to Q in equation 1. Mass is analogous to L. What is mass? M. It is in LCS circuit. It is analogous to which? L. And B is analogous to resistance R. Because if you compare with this expression, B by M into dx by dt, say B by M into dx by dt equal to what? R by L into dq by dt. So here R by L equal to what? B by M. R by L equal to what?
B by M.
B by M.
So B is analogous to which?
R.
R. Okay. And A by M, and here L, A by M equal to what?
A by M into LC.
Okay. So all the terms here that is written, the X in equation 2 is analogous to Q in equation 1. Mass M in analogous to L and B is analogous to the resistance R. Okay. Now, simply, I'm converting the equation. Simply, I'm converting the equation. Actually, it was x, na? X was e to the power minus kt, a into e to the power root over k square minus omega square t plus b into e to the power minus k square minus omega square t. This was the solution, na? In place of q, it was x initially. Today, I have discussed. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
So this was the general solution of damped vibration. Now x is analogous to q. So in place of x, what I have written?
Q.
In place of x, I have written q. Now here r by l equal to 2k. Is it? This one r by equal to l equal to what? 2k. And omega square equal to what? 1 by root over LC.
Over LC.
1 by LC.
Okay. So in large damping case or heavy damping case, what was our condition? K was?
K greater than omega. Greater than omega.
So what is K here? So R by L equal to 2K. So what is K?
R by 2L.
R by 2L.
Have I written this thing? In place of K, I have written what? R by 2L. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And in place of omega square, omega equal to 1 by root over LC. I will correct it before sending the note. So omega square equal to 1 by LC and omega equal to root over 1 by LC. So K is greater than omega. So omega is what? 1 by root over? Omega is what?
1 by root over LC.
1 by
what
LC.
What is our condition? So what is our condition in LCR circuit in damping case, large damping case? R by 12 is greater than 1 by root over LC. So remember it very carefully. And here root over K square minus omega square is real because K is greater than omega. K is greater than omega. So root over this term, K square minus omega square, is it real? Real it is. Because K is greater than omega. So this is the case of large damping case. What is this case?
Large
damping case. So students, actually, the time is over. Actually, it is 10:56 and you have probably class from again from 11. So I'm leaving the class. I'm not discussing after this. In my next class, I will discuss the remaining only 10 minutes remaining for LCR circuit for damping case. Now I will discuss the next two part. That is, what is the case? That is critical damping case and the light damping case. That I will discuss in my next class, but I'm sending you the notes, whole note I'm sending, so you can understand. Now just compare with the general differential equation of damped vibration and mechanically what I have discussed, and just compare this, you will understand very easily, no problem for you. And again, I will discuss it in my next class, the next two cases, that is critical damping case and the light damping case. Okay, so I'm ending my lecture here and must send your attendance after my class within 1 hour.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so thank you again.
Thank you, ma'am.
For attending the class, but that roll number 34 is absent today. Only one student is absent, that is roll number 34.
Thank you.